मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, इकोनॉमिक्स क्लास 11, अंडर द कंज्यूमर इक्विलिब्रियम वी आर नाउ डूइंग दिस लॉ ऑफ डिमिनिशिंग मार्जिनल यूटिलिटी मींस एज एंड इट इज आल्सो नोन एज गॉसेंस फर्स्ट लॉ ऑफ कंजम्पशन. इट वाज डेवलप्ड इन 1854 बट इट इज एसोसिएटेड more with Professor Marshall. Now, what is the statement says? The more we have a thing, the less we derive utility from it. Suppose you are very much hungry and you have started consuming the good. Now, for that, the things which we assume to be constant or other things being equal are same quality and normal size of units. Suppose you are consuming 1 teaspoon of sugar, then 1 crystal will not be considered as a unit, at least 1 teaspoon will be considered. Then continuous consumption, that 1 crystal of sugar you are taking in the morning, another 1 in the evening, that will also not be considered. It should be continuous. Then you are a normal consumer means you know how to get maximum satisfaction by consuming a commodity. Then no change in income and taste, because if it changes, the ratio of this MU will also diminish. Then independent utility means every commodity has its own utility and it is not concerned with the use of the another one. Utility can be measured. Here we are measuring it. And for measuring the utility, we use the word utils, not units. Okay. Now, for this, we can make a schedule. And we are assuming we are consuming 5 units of commodities. Then MU will be, that is also being hypothetical, 6, 4, 2, 0, minus 2. In my previous video, I have told you the relationship between TU and MU. Then we have calculated MU. So if we calculate TU, that will be 6, 10, 12, 12 and 10. And that is already shown in the form of, and here you are seeing that this is the point of satiety, you can say. Means the maximum satisfaction is being derived by the consumer. Why does the law operate? Now, each particular want is satiable, means that can be satisfied. As he consumes more, his intensity of want diminishes and MU falls. Now, the second reason for the operation of this law is goods are not perfect substitute. Marginal utility will not decrease if it could be used as a perfect substitute for other units. And this law is being applied in our day-to-day life, and how we can make the best possible use of the things it can be used on. And if we are not making the use of it, this law of diminishing, and this will also become the cause for the law of demand in future. And what we can say that it is also known as the law of diminishing marginal utility, means the more we have a thing, the less we derive utility from it.